Can you imagine?
Mess.
No.
We get like an inch. Everyone was like,
Arr! We had like a, we had a little bit of snow, and I'm walking to the grocery store trying not to slip.
Yeah.
Like an inch of snow. Yeah.
Well, I wanted to focus a little bit on national temperatures because you talk about this big storm impacting the Great Lakes, impacting the Northeast. Look at how chilly. This is current temp. So Minneapolis at -5, Billings -2, and you see that cold air, the purple color sliding down all the way into your Lone Star State, down into Texas. But when you look at the wind chill, then you're like, okay, this is ridiculous, right? So you got -20 or about there in Minneapolis, Green Bay, yeah, Wisconsin, -26, -15 in Chicago. So this just gives you an idea of how cold it is right now with this cold snap impacting a good chunk of the country. So this puts our nice 34 degrees in Seattle look a little bit more balmy, right? I'm sure you're throwing stuff at TV. Say, stop it, Jordan. This is cold. I know it is. It is cold. 34 in Everett. We've got 31 out in the Arlington area and a couple spots down around freezing. Olympia, Puyallup, I want to point you out at 32. Bellingham with the coldest temperature at 28. And those flurries that we've been tracking, we are still looking at a couple of those into tonight and tomorrow. Now, the accumulation, if we get any, will be well up to the north in Whatcom County, North Edge, right near the international border. And we could see this all transition to rain by the time we head into your Thursday evening. So here's the snow. We talked about 10 minutes ago. You could see a lot of it aligning as it heads east of I-5. You get that orographic lift, and then boom, it turns into a few flurries. Nothing really accumulating. We had a couple spots on the Kitsap Peninsula. I know we had a Twitter user in Covington say, hey, I'm seeing a few flurries. I know that we're seeing a little bit of the activity in and around the Black Diamond area just north of Enumclaw. And then we had a couple of spots in and around, let's say, the east side up towards Bellevue and Kirkland, but that's since dried up. Out south, we got a little more of that. I mean, from the coast even towards Astoria, the Columbia River, it begins to transition into the snow. And then up along your Juan de Fuca Strait, we've got some rain, snow mix happening right now on both sides of Washington and up into British Columbia. So the best chance for accumulation for us locally is going to be in the Whatcom County area up north, north of Bellingham. And then, of course, obviously up in the mountains where we've been getting some epic snowfall. For you folks who are skiers and snowboarders, get out there the next couple of days. We've got this next system that will arrive on Thursday. This is showing you some of the flurries that we could see. Maybe still a little bit of a mix up there near Bellingham by tomorrow, but it all transitions to rain in the lowlands as we head into the evening hours of Thursday, evening hours of Wednesday into your Thursday. There's your timestamp, and you can see it's a lot of rainfall. Snow level will sit at about 3,000 to 4,000 feet. So the mountains will still get packed with snow, and then we've got a lot of rainfall here locally that'll get all that snow out of here. So for tomorrow, transition day, overcast, maybe a few flurries that linger with us. Thursday's the big storm that brings a lot of rainfall. Notice temperatures are warming up, mid to upper 40s. Drying out second half of the day on Saturday, and then by New Year's Eve, Sunday, Monday, we're looking at a little bit drier conditions, you guys.